Hello everyone, welcome to Engineering and Automation YouTube channel. This video is a continuation to our previous video about the BACnet and its LAN technologies. If you haven't watched that video, I highly recommend you to watch it after this video. Before going on to the video, please consider subscribing to our channel. In today's video, we will learn about one of the most widely used BACnet LAN technologies, that is BACnet MSTP protocol. The MSTP stands for Master Slave Token Passing, which uses EAA485 standard at the physical layer. It is one of the most used physical layer technologies in building control systems, particularly for application-specific controllers such as FCU and VAV controllers. Since the EAA485 standard is a physical layer standard, BACnet defines a master-slave token passing protocol to provide the data link layer function. The logical principle behind MSTP is the token passing, that is, a signal call token is transmitted to authorize the devices for communication from one device to another over the EAA485 bus. A device can only communicate after receiving this token. MSTP distinguishes between two types of devices, the master devices and slave devices. The MSTP address range 0 to 127 may be either used for master devices or slave devices, but the address range 128 to 256 is reserved for slave devices. This permits the address space to be configured to meet the need of a specific application. Let's see in detail about master and slave devices. Slave devices. MSTP slave devices can be read or written, but never receives the token. The disadvantage of slave devices is that slave devices cannot actually send out messages and always require a master on the network to establish communication. On the other hand, it has the advantage of transferring less tokens on the EAA485 bus, which then accelerates overall communication. However, the disadvantages outweighs the advantages, so that most MSTP devices are set as master devices. Master devices. Each master device on the network periodically outputs a poll for the next master. That is, it checks its next master device's ability to forward the token. Each master device sends out a query between the own address and the next known address. For example, if the current address of the master device is 12 and the next known master device address is 22. The addresses 13 to 21 is polled periodically in ascending order to see whether a new master device was added to the network. Note that unused gaps in addresses should be avoided, since this would negatively impact the performance of a BACnet MSTP system. An MSTP network can have one or more master devices. Also, it may have a combination of master device and slave devices that are unable to transmit the messages until requested by the master device. It can also be made up entirely of master devices, forming a peer-to-peer network. Now, we will see about the RS485 standards requirement for devices that are contained on the MSTP network. The RS485 standard allows up to 32 devices with one unit load per device to be connected on a single network. The load from each device must be less than or equal to 1 milliamps drawing current. The maximum load current requirement of RS485 is 32 milliamps on a bus. The MSTP network allows up to 128 devices to be installed on a single network with one or more repeaters. Typically, only 32 devices with one unit load can be connected to a BACnet MSTP network without repeaters. However, thanks to the advancement in RS485 transceivers, we can now connect more than 32 devices on a single MSTP network without the need of repeaters. This is achieved by reducing the maximum load current of each transceiver by implementing a higher receiver input impedance. As we saw earlier, at full load, only 32 devices can be connected in a single network without repeaters. Each device maximum drawing current is 1 milliamps, with the total current drawn is 32 milliamps, which complies to the RS485 standards requirement. With higher input impedance for the RS485 transceivers, the following reduced load devices are now available. At half load, a maximum of 64 devices can be connected on a single MSTP network, with per device maximum drawing current is less than or equal to 500 microamps. So, the total current drawn on the MSTP network is still complying to the RS485 standard. Similarly, at quarter load, 128 units can be connected on a single MSTP network, with per device maximum current drawn is less than or equal to 250 microamps. Finally, at 1/8 of the load, a maximum of 256 devices can be connected on a single network, with per device drawing current is not more than 125 microamps to comply with the RS485 standard. The table here summarizes the RS485 standard's requirement. Also, the RS485 standard defines the maximum physical length of an MSTP network, that is 1200 meters or 400 feet. The communication wiring of MSTP is very important. MSTP do not support star or tree topology, as using these topologies causes pulse reflection issues on the network. The MSTP network must be installed in a proper daisy chain format. Daisy chain configuration means that there is only one main cable and every network device is connected in parallel directly along its path. The correct MSTP wiring with the daisy chain format is shown here. It is important to keep the same color for all A+ terminal wiring and different color for B- terminal. Also, the shield wires must be grounded only on one side. The recommended cable specification for an MSTP network shall be of low capacitance 22 or 24 AWG shielded to stepper cables such as Belden 9841. Now, we will see about the importance of EOL or the MSTP network. EOL stands for end of line termination. In order to avoid reflection issues, end of line resistor typically of 120 ohms must be installed at both ends of the physical network wire. As the communication is achieved by electrical pulse signal, when no end of line resistors are installed, the pulse signal reflects backwards and collides with other data pulses. The end of line resistor absorbs the pulse energy and dissipates as heat. So, EOL must be always installed on the MSTP network. Even though BACnet MSTP is officially supported by BACnet, a BACnet MSTP router is always deployed on the network to connect the MSTP devices to the management system. The router converts BACnet MSTP to BACnet IP backbone, which is the preferred communication protocol for the BMS system. Some important points to remember while selecting a BACnet MSTP systems are: BACnet MSTP system always requires routers on the network. BACnet MSTP network supports lengths up to 1200 meters. However, it should be noted that the MSTP network must be implemented only within the building. If you have multiple buildings, use separate MSTP network with routers on each building. Also, wiring must be done only in line topology following the daisy chain format. T connections, star or tree topology wiring should not be used. Only 32 unit load devices can be connected on a single network. All devices must have the same baud rate, ensuring no single devices on the network slows down the system. That's all for today's video. I hope you guys have learned something useful from this, and thanks a lot for watching this video. If you guys like the contents of this channel, please consider subscribing to our channel and click the bell icon to enable notifications. This will highly encourage me to make more videos like this. As always, please leave your feedback and suggestions in the comment section. Also, like this video, share this video with your friends, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thank you.